Hi guys, welcome to part two. You know, they say that beauty is only skin deep. Well, in this pyramid, it's a beauty, but we're only after the skin. In other words, the surface area, the total complete exterior covering of this particular pyramid right over here. Now, we're gonna take it in four steps. Now, the first step, what we need to do, as I mentioned in part one, is we need to find this slant height across there. And that's equivalent to this right over there, yeah? So that's what we're gonna find. Does that make sense? And then after that, what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually use that slant height, because that becomes the vertical perpendicular height of that face, of that triangle. We're gonna use half times base times height to work out the area of that face. Then all we need to do is multiply that by four, because there are four triangle faces all the way around. And then finally, what we need to do is work out this area under here. That's the base. It's a square base, so that's going to be pretty easy. It's going to be 10 by 10. And all we have to do to finalize this is to add up all those sides, all five sides, to come up with a complete, total, entire surface covering and skin of this pyramid. So let's start at part one, and that is to work out this slant height right across there. We're going to use a guy named Pythagoras. He came up with the Pythagoras' theorem. We're after the hypotenuse, as you can see here. So let's start to fill all this in. So the hypotenuse across here is what we're looking for, and that's actually S, the slant height across there, because that's the face right in there. We want those front triangle faces flat on the ground. That's what we want. So how do we do that? Well, that slant's what's missing. Now let's have a look at the dimensions we do have. Well, we do have 12, which is the vertical height right there. That's the perpendicular height from the base, in the middle of the square, all the way up to the apex or the peak. And that's 12. Now, across here is halfway across. So the only way we can find this is by observing this diagram here displayed here. We have this corner to that corner, and that's 10 centimeters. So if we halve that, that's going to be 5 centimeters, because that's going to be halfway between there and there, yeah? So let's put down 5 here. Okay, there's our right angle triangle. Now we can use Pythagoras' theorem. So let's do that right now. So it's going to be, we're looking for the hypotenuse, so therefore it's going to be S squared, which is the slant height, equals 12 squared plus 5 squared. So let's work this out. 12 squared, 12 times 12 is 144. And 5 squared is 25. Now, that's S squared. Let's add them together. 144 plus 25 together, all together, total is 169. What we need to do with that 169 is to square root that, because that's S squared. Therefore, S, the slant length, which is right across there, because when we flatten it, that's going to be the perpendicular height of that triangle. The square root of 169 is 13 centimeters. And now let's use that for step number two, so we can work out the actual area of that face. Now, to work out the area of that face, because it's the same as all the other three faces, we need to draw up that little triangle. So let me draw that. There's our perpendicular height of the face. That's 13. We just worked it out now. Now across the base, it's 10, isn't it? So that's 10. So we use the formula half times base times height. I'm sure many of you are aware of that formula. That's the area of a triangle. And we have the perpendicular height in order to do that. So area equals So that's going to be And the base is 10, and the height is 13. So let's work that out. Half times 10 is 5. 5 times 13 is 65. So that means the area of this face is 65 centimeter squared. Now that we have that, how many other faces do we have? We have another three, so altogether there are four of them. So all we need to do is multiply that by four to get face, 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 face. There are four triangular faces covering this square pyramid. So let's multiply that by four, so it's going to be 4 times 65 on our calculator is 260. So that's the collective triangles. There's four of them. So that's the triangular part. That's four of them. Now all we need to do is add the square base down the bottom right here. Now that is 10 centimeters by 10. It's a perfect square. So 10 times 10 is 100. That's the area of the base of the pyramid. That's going to be 100. Let me write that down. All we need to do now is add up all five faces. There are four here for the triangle, and there's one square base. Add that together, and that's going to give us the complete, entire, total surface area, skin covering of this square pyramid. So let's work that out now. So it's 260. Plus 100, add 100 to 260 is 360, and that's in centimeters squared, the total surface area of this square pyramid. Let's write that up.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.